Hello, I'm Keith Graham, Codasip's Vice President of University Program. I'd like to introduce you to your first assignment in either computer organization or computer architecture. You'll be using a program called Codasip Studio to actually design a five-stage RISC-V processor. Now, let's enter the tool so you can get a feel of what it looks like. Now, you can see that I'm in Chrome, in a Chrome browser. Codasip Studio has only been validated to work in Chrome or Firefox, so you must be one of those two browsers. So let's go into your website to get to Codasip Studio, which is studio.in.cloud, and it will bring up a login box. So you'll be getting your username and password from your professor. So I'm just going to enter my credentials. And you'll see that it will come up with another pop-up box asking me to create a pod. Basically, this works. You're basically creating your workspace, which will be your file system and access to all the software in Codasip Studio. So I'm going to click on Create, and then it's going to come up with a click-through license agreement. Read it completely. There's several pages on it. It's very similar to the click-throughs that you might receive when you actually log or install a new piece of software on your phone or your computer. But please read it very carefully, and only if you agree to the terms, hit accept. When you hit accept, Codasip Studio will create your own personal workspace. And then it will come up with another pop of asking you to open, which is to get into your workspace, or tear down. Do not click on tear down unless specifically told by your professor. Teardown removes your file system, you lose all your work. Once again, do not click on teardown unless specifically told by your professor. Now I'm going to enter my workspace by clicking open. Now I'm in my workspace. Now you can see that there's two toolbars. There's one at the top, which is more like your classic toolbar with file, view, and so forth. And then this toolbar on your left. And these are what I call your different perspectives. And it gets you to, or puts into the foreground, different parts of the application of Codasip. And we'll go through several of those here in this short video. Now, first of all, you're going to need to import your CODAL, which is your processor project, and an assembly project for assignment one. So let me show you how you're going to do that. Now, to do that, you're going to need a terminal window. So go up to terminal, click on New Terminal, and you'll get a dialog box down here. We are using a Git clone with a GitHub address to pull in both your processor model and your assembly model. So you go down here, type in Git clone. You can see that it just installed an application or software into my workspace. Now, right now you don't see anything. So let's go to the first perspective on the upper left. These two files are your file explorer perspective. So I click on that, and now you can see under projects that I actually do have a project called IA for Instruction Accurate, RISC-V 32i. Now if I expand that, you can see the files within that project. And if I expand model, these are all the files that would actually contain the information that describes the architecture of your RISC-V 32 computer. Now, let me show you what it looks like for an assembly program. So let's go back down to your terminal, and we're going to do a Git clone. And now I'm going to get the address for that project. And now you can see another project came into my file explorer. It's assignment one program, and if I expand that, you can see it looks different. This is an assembly program. Now if I expand the source folder, I have a file with a .s. Now .s signifies that this file is an assembly program. Now to edit this, which you will have to do in this assignment, you just click it and it will open up your assignment file or any other file you do click up in the main window in the middle of your workspace. Now I can edit this just like any other file, in Word or email and so forth. But when you finish editing it, you will save it by clicking File and then clicking Save or Save All. So this is how you would save it. Now, once I have my two projects in there, I need to actually prepare or compile my RISC-V design. Right now, this is just a model of the instructions and not the actual design itself, but we need to compile it so we can actually then use it as an assembler and a compiler. Now, for that, we're going to go to a different perspective called workflow. And you can see down here on the left, my workflow perspective. Now, once I click on workflow, you'll see that I have my two projects and they have two different icons. We have this one icon right here, and this is for all your C programs in assembly. And this one here with the sort of the beaker is your processor set of projects. Now, if I expand both, you can see that I have different sets of workflow or applications to perform on a particular type of project, either assembly C or a Codal project. Now, under my Codal project or my processor project, I need to generate the files so that I can use it to compile, debug, and simulate my assembly program above. So to do that, you're going to click on Gen SDK. SDK stands for Software Development Kit. So I click on that, and then I'm going to select IA for Instruction Accurate Model, which once again contains all the files you need to compile a program and simulate and debug it as well. So I click on that, and it will initiate Generate SDK. This will take approximately 3 minutes, so I'm going to pause this video, and I'll be back in a few minutes. Now you can see that I'm finished building or generating my software development kit. If you come down here, you can see build finish. Now I want to show you or validate to you that it has completed. So we're going to go down to look at this perspective called Codasip Studio Tools. And I'm going to open up this tool. And then I'm going to expand my IA module or my processor design. And you can see that all the tools including SDK IA above it have a check mark, which means that they are compiled and ready to be used. And so you can see that it includes the assembler, disassembler, simulator, linker, all your C libraries in your C compiler. So it shows all the software that has been developed or actually built from your actual processor design. Now, if you don't have Codasip Studio on your taskbar or your on your left menu bar, you can get to it by clicking on View, Open View, and you can see Codasip Studio. You can click that, and then it will add that perspective on your left-hand toolbar if it's not already there. Now let's go back to the workflow perspective, and you can see that the C program or the assembly programs have a different workflow. For example, I have to assign, if I have more than one processor model, I have to assign which processor model that this program will be used to compile and run the debugger. So we also have another perspective called the debugger, which we'll learn more about in another video for this assignment, because you will be using the debugger for assignment one. Now, the last thing I'd like to show you in this introductory video is there's going to be a time where you're going to have to submit a file for grading purposes. So you're going to have to download a file. So the best way to do that is to go to your workflow perspective, select your file that you want to download. And in this case, in this assignment, will be assignment one test. Now, if you right click it, come down, and there is the option to download. This is how you will download your first assignment for this course. So that's a quick introduction to your first assignment, and good luck.